Good morning students. In this class I'll be doing class 10 CBSE syllabus 11th chapter constructions. Exercise 11.1 second sum. Construct a triangle of sides 4 cm, 5 cm and 6 cm and then a triangle similar to it whose sides are 2 by 3 of the corresponding sides of the first triangle. So we'll take the largest side as the base as 6 cm. So first we will directly will go to the construction of triangle. So the baseline we'll take it as BC as 6 cm, then 4 cm and 5 cm on the other two sides. So first 4 cm, so with B 4 cm, then the other one is 5 cm. 5 cm, then I will join these two lines. I will get the sides of the triangle AB and AC. So AB is 4 cm and AC is 5 cm. So for this triangle, I need to construct a similar triangle for this. Okay, so for constructing a similar triangle, with B, I will make an angle of 60 degrees. First one arc, then I will cut the previous arc. I will get an angle of 60 degrees. Okay, then with any measurement, since the measurement of the similar triangle is in the ratio 2:3, I will take any measurement. With any measurement with B, I will cut 3 arcs. So 1, 2, and then 3. So I'll be naming it as B1, B2 and B3. So B3 and C I will join. So since the fraction is given as 2 by 3, I will get a triangle, similar triangle inside this bigger triangle. So this is third line. So I have joined this B3 and C. So I need to construct a parallel line from B2 to a point on the line BC. So this is parallel line construction that already you have learnt in the lower classes. So with B3, with any measurement, I will cut an arc. Then the same way with B2, I will cut another arc. Already we have learnt in the lower classes regarding the property of the parallel lines that the corresponding angles are equal. So we have to draw a parallel line to B3C. Since we have to construct a parallel line, the corresponding angles will be equal. So we will get a corresponding angle here, that is from this point to this point. Whatever angle we are getting, we have to get it on the line where we are to construct a parallel line. So this is the measurement of the corresponding angle, so that from the second line I will cut the, so this is the second arc I have drawn. So this is the first arc. From this point I have constructed the second arc. Okay, from B3 I am telling. Then so that measurement I will take, the parallel line measurement, that is the corresponding angle. Then from the second arc I will cut that. So then B2 and this one has to be joined. So this is B2 and this one is, this is the point of intersection. When I join this, I will get a line that is parallel to BC. See here. So the same procedure has to be followed for the other part of the original triangle also. From C, with any measurement, I will cut an arc. Then this point where BC meets, from there also I will cut another arc. Then I will measure the angle here. So the same angle I have to get it here also. So I will cut it here. Then from this point, that is, we'll name this as C dash. Okay. So with this C dash, from the C dash, I will join this. So I will get a parallel line here. So this one also I will name it as A dash. So A dash C dash is parallel to AC. So with the help of this B to C dash, I will be constructing a line that is parallel to AC, that is A dash C dash. So A dash C AC and A dash C dash is parallel to each other. Okay. So the required triangle is, similar triangle is this. So we are asked to construct a similar triangle for the given measurement. So original triangle is ABC. So we got a similar triangle for that as A dash B C dash. So thus A dash C, C dash B, A dash C dash B is the required similar triangle. Required similar triangle. Okay. So we need to do the justification also. So the justification is, justification for this is, we have constructed B3C parallel to B2C dash. That is, B3C is parallel to B2C dash. So this is by construction. So we have constructed that one. So that is equal to, that implies, that implies B, B2, B, B2 divided by B2, B3, B2, B3 is equal to B, C dash by C dash C. B B2 divided by B2 B3 is equal to B C dash divided by C dash C. So this is by Thales theorem, that is basic proportionality theorem. When the sides are parallel, they are proportional to each other. Okay. But B, B2 by B2, B3 is equal to 2 by 1. So, this is 2 part and this is 1 part. 2 by 1. So, this implies B, C dash by C dash C. Both these are equal. So, this is equal to 2 by 1. So, all these things as justification we need to write after constructing this. So, BC dash by C dash C is equal to 2 by 1. So, this implies when we are finding the reciprocal, C dash C by BC dash, we will get it as 1 by 2. When you are reciprocaling, when you are finding the reciprocal of this, this side also will get reciprocal. Okay. So, adding 1 on both sides. Adding 1 on both sides. So, when we add 1 on both sides, we'll get C dash C by BC dash plus 1 is equal to 1 by 2 plus 1. So, adding 1 on both sides. Okay. So, here we'll get, we get C dash C plus BC dash by BC dash. I am adding this is equal to 1 plus 2 by 2. So here C dash C, see here, C dash C plus BC dash will be BC in the numerator divided by BC dash is equal to 3 by 2. Is equal to 3 by 2. So that is when we are finding the reciprocal, BC dash by BC is equal to 2 by 3 will get. So now in triangle BC dash A dash, that is BC dash A dash, that is the smaller triangle, and the original triangle BCA, we have CA parallel to, see here, CA parallel to C dash A dash, parallel to C dash A dash. So using AA similarity, using AA similarity, we can say that triangle BC dash A dash is similar to triangle BCA, is similar to triangle BCA. So this implies all the sides are proportional, that is A dash B by AB is equal to A dash C dash by AC is equal to B C dash by BC is equal to 2 by 3. So all the sides are proportional. So this is the thing we have to prove. So this is the justification after doing this diagram. After constructing this triangle, we need to do this justification also. Okay. So we have to get it as 2 by 3. Okay. Thank you.